Writing clean code, whether it's in React or Python or any other library or language or whatever you're using, is really difficult. Like, trust me, I get it. I struggled with this for so much when I was learning to actually code and become a developer. And I know that a lot of you are also struggling with this as well. But I genuinely believe that if you follow a few set of very simple rules and apply them across your entire project, you're going to make it virtually impossible for you to actually write bad code. And in this video, I want to show you one of those rules. And I'm telling you, if you watch this video and you follow this rule, you're going to be a much better developer. So strap in, get ready, get excited, because you're going to learn a lot in this video. All right, let's begin. Now, first, I want to give credit where credit is due. This video is inspired by this article here, The Magic of Keeping One Level of Abstraction Per Function. And it's written by, let's see here, it's written by Timek Zapata, or Zapata because you're from Poland. Again, I'm not sure, I probably mispronounced this, but this is a really great article. I highly recommend that you check it out. You'll find a link to it in the description. And this actually comes from our Import React newsletter, which, if you don't know, is a free newsletter that you get articles like this, tips and tricks about React, delivered to your inbox every single week. If you also want to join that, I highly recommend it. It's completely free. It's also going to be linked in the description. Cool. So what we have here is essentially two components that are completely identical. They're functionally equivalent. They do the same thing. Their only difference is that the code that is written to actually make them work could not be more different. And you're going to see, hopefully, very clearly that there's one way of doing things that is completely wrong and inefficient, and that there's another way of doing things that is completely right and efficient, and also follows this rule, which is to keep one level of abstraction per function, or in our case for React, per component. And I'm going to come here and prove to you that these work, right? So these are essentially simple password inputs, and as you type your password, you're gonna get this updated here that tells you how weak or strong a password you actually have. So let's first start here. I'm not gonna tell you which one is which in terms of the good one and the bad one, code-wise, but it shouldn't make a difference. We're going to see that when we get to the actual code. So here I'm going to type 123, 123, and then 12 to get 8 characters. Then we're going to put one number to get numbers. We're going to put one special character and then one uppercase. And now we have a strong password and we're fully green, which is great. That's what we want to see. For this one, we're going to do the same thing. 123, 123, 12. Then we're going to put here a number. We're going to put here a special character and an uppercase. And there we go. We have exactly the same thing. They work exactly in the same way. But like I said, the code could not be more different. So now let's go look at the code and let's see what we're actually dealing with. All right. So here we have the code, and this is the app2 component. And I'm going to tell you right off the bat, I hope that you can guess by now, this is the bad component. This is the one that you shouldn't really write in your applications. And we're going to see exactly why. So let's take a look at this component. So we have app2 over here. So first we have this one state variable here called password, right? This is the actual password that as we're typing gets updated. And you can see it here, right? We have this h1 tag, we have this password strength checker, and then we have our input here, right? It receives the password as its value, and then it actually on change sets the password with e.target.value, and that is going to update this component here, and it's going to cause, very importantly to know, this entire component to rerun and to regenerate all of the JSX within it. And then as we scroll down, we're going to see here there are some helpful comments that can hopefully indicate to you what we're doing wrong here, right? Let's look at this code over here, right? Because this is very interesting. So here we have a div, and then we have a class name here, which is used to actually set classes on this actual div. And then in the actual class name, we have this JavaScript that we're interpolating here that makes all of these different checks on the password, right? And I just want to like run a test by you before we go further in this video. Just like, tell me, leave a comment down below. How long would it take you to actually understand what this is and what this is doing, right? Because it's not obvious, at least to me, right? It's not obvious what we're doing here. I know we're checking some things with the password, but what are we actually achieving? Why are we putting this in the div here and specifically in this class name property? Right, because if you look here, we're checking password.length is greater or equal than 8, fine. Then we're running some regex text on this, and we're actually, yeah, we're doing another regex test as well. Then we have more of them, and then we have more of them, and then we're applying some classes here, which is not really obvious what it is that we're actually doing. Like, what are the classes? Why are we applying them? What's with full, with two-thirds and one-thirds, what do they actually relate to, right? And it's very, very difficult to really understand what is going on, right? So that's one problem. That's a big problem. The second problem is, as this comment suggests here, we have complex conditional logic mixed with the UI. You have to understand that we're inside of the JSX here. We're in the part to render actual UI. And we have these like strange computations here that make this really complicated, really bloated, and very difficult to work with. Honestly, imagine you had to come into our project and you had to actually contribute to this and change whatever this is to something else. First of all, how would you figure out where it is that you actually have to go and make the change? And then second of all, how would you like make sure that you're actually making the change correctly? What if you had to change the password length from 8 to like 10, right? Maybe you would take this and ideally you would like select the next one and check if there's another one. And then you see there's more here and you're like, why is this always here, right? You have duplicated code. And then we have it here at the bottom. Like, what is all of this, right? Like, you can't guarantee that if you change all of this code here, you're going to make the changes. Maybe there's some code in this other part of the application, because if this code looks like this in this component, you can imagine how the rest of the application looks like. Maybe there's a point in the application, some other code that is also going to affect this, right? You don't know, because it's not clearly obvious, and that's a very big sign of bad code. That's a red flag. It's a code smell. And then you saw it, right? If you keep scrolling down here, we actually have the same thing here. We have duplicated logic. And this is, again, the same logic, but it's doing something else. And here, at least, maybe you can kind of realize what is going on, right? We have this strong here, weak and medium, which if I go back here to the application, is actually this over here. As we actually change our password, it goes to medium and then it goes to weak, right? That is actually what is going on. And then you can kind of interpolate that, oh, this might also be that progress bar, right? With full and then background green 500, that's when it's full, right? And then here it's when it's middle and here it's when it's not, when it's a weak password. You can kind of guess, right? But that's the thing, you have to guess, you have to spend time, effort, and energy. And if you're not a good developer, if you're just learning, if you're like, haven't seen this in the world, you might get overwhelmed and have no idea what to do. And that is completely understandable. And I get it. It's difficult. Don't write code like this. And then, you know, the rest of it just kind of continues, right? You have another password check here, which is another for something else, right? Then you're making the same check here again for the actual check mark or the actual circle over here, right? And we're doing the same thing here for the password for another test. It's just a bunch of the same thing. It's a lot of copy paste. And I'm 100% sure that the person who wrote this were lazy developers, and the only thing that they did is they took this and they're like, oh, let's add a new one, let's come here, let's paste it, and then let's just change this over here, this regex, let's change it for, I don't know, something else, whatever, and then put some other text over here, and that's it. They call it a day, they moved on, and that's the way that they write code. But this is code that doesn't scale, it's not efficient, it's difficult to understand, and it makes working with this a nightmare. Trust me, I've worked with this, I know what it's like, it's a nightmare. Please don't do this. So now I'm going to show you the actual correct way to do things, and the way that is, in my opinion, significantly better and still achieves the same thing. So here we have app, and this is the app component number one. This is the good one. This is the one in the normal position. So what I want you to first remember is we're going to keep this in mind, one level of abstraction per function, which essentially means that we're not going to nest multiple functionalities in our components in our functions. We're going to create functions as we need them and actually delegate those functionalities to keep one level of abstraction. This is very similar to my design pattern that I always talk about, which is the single responsibility principle. Everything, every component, every function should only do one thing. This is kind of goes hand in hand with the one level of abstraction, because if you have one level of abstraction, you're generally only doing one thing, right? So this is what this code does. So over here, we have the app component, right? And then we have some div here with some styles, pretty simple stuff. We have this H1 that says password strength checker. That's the same thing as we had before, but already we stop there. And then we create one component, right? And then we delegate everything else to this other component. And that's it, right? Single responsibility principle, one layer of abstraction. We're not making more complex this component. We're delegating things to other components. Then we have the password checker component over here. We have the state variable password, right? Which is the same thing as we had before. That gets passed here to the password input. We're passing the value as a password. And then the onChange set password function. We're also passing it here to the requirements list. So again, right, we're keeping one layer of abstraction and we're separating everything into separate components and separate functions. And then for the strength over here, we also have this evaluate password strength function, which receives the password and returns a strength. And then that strength gets passed over here to the strength indicator component, right? This is efficient, this is clean, and this looks much better. Then scrolling down, we have the password input component, receives the value and the onChange, right, as props. And then all that it does is it just returns the actual input with the value and then the onChange and some styles. That's all that it does. But we've put this in a separate component, which is good. And then we're using that component in here, which also allows us to use this password input in any other component that might need to have a password input. So that's great. That's efficient once again. Then for the strength indicator, we receive the strength over here. And then based on that, we set some colors here for weak, medium, and strong. And then all that we do is we pass here as a class name, the actual background color right here. We still do some interpolation, that's fine. But look at how much simpler this is versus what we had before, right? Like we had all of this here in the class name, right? Versus this, it's literally just one line, like less than one line of code, right? And then we're also passing the actual strength by using getStrengthPercentage, which gets the actual strength value from the props. Right, so I hope that you're seeing the pattern that we're actually employing here. We're keeping things very simple. Things are only doing one thing, and we're keeping one layer of abstraction. We're never going beyond that, right? We're passing values to different functions, different components, and we just keep going that way, keep creating more functions and more components that each only do one thing. And then we're putting all of those together to actually make something that still does the same thing as we had it before, but is actually a lot better and a lot easier to read and understand and to develop and work with. Then we have our requirements list component. It receives the password as props and then sets here an array of requirements. Each one has a label and then a function that determines if this requirement is met here, right? And yet, as you can see, has minimum length, we pass the password. Has numbers, we pass the password. Has special characters, we pass the password. Every single one of these functions here is abstracted away, right? And we're not doing all of the logic inside of the requirements list, right? So this is really great. And then what we're returning here is some styles for the actual wrapper to be able to loop over all of those. And then for every requirement, we're looping through them and we're also creating and using another component, the requirement item component. So again, we passed it to another component that does one thing. And this one, all that it does, it just renders us some UI. And this here puts the actual colors and then the check here that says check or circle, and then the label based on the actual met value here, right? So again, very efficient. And then here at the bottom, we have our functions, our utility functions that checks if the password has minimum length, if it has numbers and so on. And then we also have a valid password strength, which uses those functions, right? And then just returns the actual value of the password. And then we have another function that returns the percentage, and we're using all of those in the components to actually see and do and function our results. So really, same code, right? These two components have the same code. They look identically the same, right? They function the same, but I mean, not the same code, sorry, the same functionality. The code is different, right? But their code is so different. And it's night and day, right? I mean, I hope that you get it. It's like really night and day, right? And now going back to the example, let's say that you want to change here the password from 8 to 10, right? Here, it's difficult. And this component is difficult. You have no guarantees that you're changing the actual correct things. But here in this case, where would you do it? And more importantly, you've now seen the code, but like if I asked you to go change the password length, how long would it take you to actually do it, right? It would be pretty simple. You would scroll down, you'd see, okay, where's the password defined? Oh, the password is here, it's being passed here. Let's see, okay. Where are we like doing our validation? So let's see, oh, we have here evaluate password strength. Okay, let's see what this function does. Oh, it has checks, has minimum length, has numbers. Oh, we have has minimum length. That seems like the place we wanna go. Oh, password.length 8. If I come here and I select this and I try to select others, there's no other instances of this code. It's the only code there. So if I wanna change this to 10, well, we're just gonna put 10 in here and that change is going to be reflected anywhere in our application because we have the guarantee that it's only in one function. And if you wanna have this functionality in any other place, you would just use that function. You won't just rewrite the same code. You would use the function. So if you change it here, you change it everywhere. Right? That's how this works. And just generally, like you look at this code, this is a pleasure to look at and to work with, right? If you're a new developer here, even if you're new, I send you this code and I give you some simple tasks to do, you're gonna be able to do it. And you already know the patterns to do, right? You already know that if you wanna add some things, you either add a new component, add a new function, and just use that, right? There's a very clear pattern here. In here, it's a mess, it's the Wild West, no one really knows what's going on. Any developer can come in here and write anything that they want, and it's just gonna ultimately not scale and be a nightmare for everyone that is working and that is involved, right? Again, I've lived this. This is not good. Don't do this, but do this instead. And this is all possible because we're following this rule. We're keeping one layer of abstraction and we're following the single responsibility principle. Now, there is an argument to be made because if you look here, if you scroll down here, we actually have more code technically. We have here 144 lines of code, right? Here in this component, we have less code. We have 100 less, just a little over 100 lines of code. So you could make the argument that now what we've done is we wrote more code, which is fair. We did. We technically did. What we also did, right, is we created a bunch more components, a bunch more functions and stuff like that. And even though we kept it simple, we put this in just one file. Ideally, you would put all of these different things in multiple files, right? So that's also a lot of work. We've created more files and more stuff like that. So there is an argument to be made that this is more work. But in my opinion, the benefit that you get from having clear code like this that is easy to understand is far superior than the fact that you just have to write more code. I would much prefer writing more code, having more files, having to jump through multiple steps to understand what's going on, than having to work through this, because this is all a big mess. It's all one thing and there are no steps to jump through. It's literally a blob of information and figure it out, deal with it, do what you can with it. Here, at least I have steps, I have some order, I have some patterns, and the more that I go through these steps, the more that I will understand the patterns, the easier it will be to go through other steps in the future, because those steps will also follow the same patterns. So in my opinion, this is significantly better. And I would highly recommend that you take a look at this code. You can have access to it. There's a repository. It's going to be linked in the description. You take a look at this code and you really understand and follow through and generally understand the differences between these two types of code and really try to adapt your code in your own applications to look more like this. Because I promise you, this is how senior developers write code. And if you start writing code like this, you're going to get more job opportunities. People are going to love working with you and you're going to be a much better developer, which ultimately is the entire goal of my channel, is the entire goal of everything that I do here and what I want for you. So please take this resource. Again, it's going to be linked in the description on GitHub. Follow it, understand this, and then start applying it to your own projects. And I promise you, you will not look back and you will be a significantly better developer. If you enjoy this video and you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure to leave this video a big thumbs up. You can also click here to subscribe, or you can click here to watch a different video of mine that YouTube seems to think that you're really going to enjoy. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Cousin. This is Cousin Solutions. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.